Happy Monday, all you mentees. This is the Uncanny Omar from Nearman Condition. And join me today for an advanced look at the Lucifer Omnibus Volume 2 from DC Comics. So please stay tuned. And welcome back, everybody. Now, this book is due out in the direct market on November 4th, and then a couple of weeks later in the book market. And I'm sure you've already noticed from the intro, this logo right there. So I thought with Absolute Swamp Thing Volume 2 that this would have a DC Black Label logo on it, but it doesn't. Not as OCD as I used to be, but this makes me really happy just to see both of these lined up together inside of a bookshelf with the DC Vertigo logo where the book actually took place. And here's the back of each book. I'm sure this was not planned because these are all taken from covers, but this makes actually a really cool collage image. And speaking of images, this image for the second omnibus is taken from the final issue, issue 75. And we're going to look at what all this collects in here in a little bit. Let's look at it under this dust jacket. It's a nice image and it's red. I don't know if y'all remember, but the original first volume was blue. We'll look at them together here in a second. And then just red on the back. So it looks like some planning went into making these two omnis. They look really well together. And there you have it. Now, let's get this opened. One thing I didn't note was giving credit to the artist. This is Christopher Moeller's painting. He's the one that does a lot of the covers. And then later on, he's joined by Michael Kaluta in the book. Here's what our bookend pages look like. Lucifer Omnibus Volume 2. Here's all the credit. And then the table of contents, which, before you ask, does come in handy because this book has actual page numbers. Here's a foreword and an introduction by Peter Gross, who was the main artist on the book and who Mike Carey considers his co-author on this book. And there is an introduction here by Mike Carey, both of them written in 2020. This is the same team that went on to do the Unwritten comic book series, which I need to freaking check out because I love the series and I have no idea why I didn't ever go and read the Unwritten. But here we are with Lucifer Volume 2. All 1,040 pages collecting Lucifer 36 all the way to 75, which is where the run ends. And then there is a little story from the House of Mystery. I think it was the House of Mystery Annual number 2 that Mike Carey went back and wrote, even though he swore off that he was not going to write the character anymore. But regardless, we are kicking off where the last omnibus left off. There's a war that's about to happen, and I'm not going to give any spoilers as I normally don't when I do these overviews. Now, one thing I need to say is, I'm sure I don't have to say this if you're watching the video already, but with a name like Lucifer, I figure you're already staying away for those people that can't deal with books like this. And that is that this is, you know, a fictional world, but it has a lot of Judeo-Christian in here. So there's a lot of Judeo-Christianity in the stories in here. And there's some Buddhism and things like that, but that comes later into play. But if you can't stand stories like this, or Sandman, or Preacher, then stay away. For those of you that are still joining me, man, if you've not read this, you all are in for a treat. So everything that Mike Carey was doing towards the beginning of the first omnibus seems like he was building up for this big war. So we have two giant wars that are about to happen, and I'm not going to give any spoilers away. But for those of you reading it for the first time, you are in for a treat. For those of you reading it for the first time, do not expect to find the Lucifer from the TV show in these pages, nor the Sandman Lucifer. Yes, it is that same Lucifer from Sandman, but he is so different. That Lucifer sounds less and less like Neil Gaiman's Lucifer, and more like Mike Carey's own Lucifer. Like Mike Carey, and this happened in the very first volume, Mike Carey finds his own voice for the character. And it's a lot different, and you'll be able to tell. Now, because there are a lot of similarities between Lucifer and Sandman. I mean, both of them were Vertigo series, both of them lasted 75 issues, and my favorite similarity is issue number 50, Lilith. That's right. I'm sure you're looking at this artwork right now, and you already know what I'm going to talk about. This is the majestic P. Craig Russell, same artist that worked on Sandman number 50, is working on Lucifer number 50. That's freaking awesome. And yeah, there's a few more similarities between these comics, but I mean, really, Lucifer is its own thing. Now, that's just P. Craig Russell doing one issue, by the way. The rest of the book is literally Peter Gross, Ryan Kelly, and Dean Ormston. Those are the guys that really put this book together. There's a few fill-in issues here and there, but most of the time, it's those three artists that are working together to bring this out in a monthly series. So everything is about to come to a head. Everything is about to wrap up for Lucifer Morningstar. So you have returning characters, and it's good to see a lot of these returning characters come back. And they're coming back in different ways from their first appearance. And I'm mainly talking about somebody like Elaine. Elaine first appeared, I think she was like in issue 4 or 5. But her role in the world of Lucifer is about to change. But she's not alone. There's also Lilith and Christopher Rudd. Everybody's role is changing. And all of it kind of ties back in. There's a lot of flashbacks. And then we even go back to Sandman, like to his first appearance. Not to spoil anything, but they do touch upon that. And my favorite storyline is collected in this omnibus right here, and that is the Morningstar storyline. It has got some badass imagery that I don't know if I can show because most of the battle will just ruin what happens, why they're fighting. And I don't want to do that. So it's going to be just look at images like this. That is freaking awesome, right? This is what to expect in Morningstar for the most part. Just these epic, gigantic battles. And I can't imagine anybody but Peter Gross actually drawing the book. And here's some Kaluta artwork now that he's doing the covers. Now let's look at something that I have to show you all that happens in my book. And this is why I always tell people, even if you're just buying the book to put on a shelf, open it up and open it up like I've shown you all how to do in my video, because you never know when quality control is going to fail. So here's what happened to my copy. In the very last issue, probably one of the best issues during one of the best parts, 10 pages are like this, are just ripped. And I was so pissed off because I love this comic book. There are important things that are happening between these pages and the final issue. That's all I can show, by the way. I'll go back here. And it seems like quality control just lets things like that slide. It's not just DC. I'm not sure if you've seen my Ven Omnibus, my very first one, Ven Omnibus Volume 1. When I got it, there were about 10 pages that were all glued together. That I can unglue and I don't mind. But this, oh man, this breaks my heart. Especially when a book is retailing at $125. So check your books, always. I don't know what DC's return policy is. Right now, it's non-existent because once this book goes out of print, who knows when they'll restock it. We're still waiting on Paul Dini Batman, right? A lot of people didn't even get Gotham by Gaslight Uncanny Omar. So what I'm trying to say is at least open it up and maybe whoever you bought it from could have some kind of return policy. It really is up to the publishers, right? And it's just things like that. It's pretty crappy quality control, but what are you going to do? Anyway, that's just a small gripe. I wanted to keep that towards the end of the overview so it didn't ruin or offset the mood of the overview because I still think this book is wonderful and I cannot believe we're getting a volume 2. It was one of my most anticipated books this month. Hey, there's Imp. And the other thing I need to say, and I'm sure I don't need to say it if you've read Volume 1, but this does have a lot of sex, a lot of nudity, a lot of violence. So if that stuff turns you off, then I'm sorry. I probably should have said that at the beginning, huh? That one's on me. Let's look at the extras in the back here. And there is an afterword from the 2006 release of the trade paperback by Mike Carey. And it's funny because in that outro, he talks about how he does not ever want to write the story of Lucifer again. He said, there's other people, Lucifer does not belong to me. And then a few years later, he comes back and does that Halloween special, which is collected right after his afterword. So that was pretty interesting. I love looking at stuff like this. This is behind the scenes artwork. And then here's the cover process. That is a beautiful sketch right there. Just amazes me how talented some people are that even their sketches, the things that they end up throwing away, it's so much better than I can do. And then you have the small little bios of where you can find some of these people. Now, let's look at this binding because that is important. I'm sure you could probably tell that it was sewn binding, but look at this eye. Holy crap, that's impressive. Making splash pages just so much easier to see. Now, with DC's Omnis, they usually use a lot of glue on the spine here, on the binding. So that sometimes makes the beginning pages start to shut, like when you're towards the front of the book. But actually, this one's laying down pretty good. I didn't have the, and honestly, the first volume was okay too. So, there you have it. Other than the ripped pages in the back from just my copy, I'm sure. It's a beautiful book. And that, as they say, is that. And when the book comes out, you can pick it up from our sponsor, CheapGraphicNovels.com, your online source for collected editions up to 50% off retail price. Cheap Graphic Novels prides itself on excellent packaging, so your stuff gets to you in excellent condition, and they have amazing customer service. Check out their bargain deals for up to 90% off cover price. And for all you minties that are watching, if you're a first-time customer, don't forget to mention that Near Mint Condition sent you their way for a promotional credit on free shipping on your next order. Now, this is only for U.S. customers. CheapGraphicNovels.com, your source for the hottest books with deep discounts, customer service, and excellent shipping that will keep you coming back for more. And that was the content, page count, and the build of this omnibus. Let me know in the comments down below if you're going to pick it up, if you already have volume one, if you already have the fat traits, the skinny traits, the original. I almost started singing the Armor Hot Dog song, skinny books, fat books. Anyway, if you already have the single issues and don't want to upgrade, or if you've never read it and you're an omnibus collector, let me know in the comments down below if you're planning on picking it up. If you're also surprised and shocked that it has the DC Vertigo logo on it, like I am. And if you've read anything from the New 52 with Lucifer in it, because I haven't, this is the only Lucifer I've read outside of Sandman's. So I don't know if any of the other series are worth checking out. And if they are, please let me know in the comments down below. Again, this was the Uncanny Omar. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget that we have a Redbubble and a Patreon. Those are amazing ways to support the channel. All of that is in the description down below. More importantly, please, everybody, stay healthy, stay safe, and much love to all of you.